Hallo en welkom to the first part of the new ASTIX tutorial series. In this tutorial I'm going to explain the main functions of LXX and how to start using the program. I'm doing this because I want to give something back to the awesome laser enthusiasts community, mainly on photonlexicon.com. Also, I found myself explaining LXX to several new users on Skype, and I didn't mind doing that, but I had to explain the same thing over and over again, and it's a bit pointless to do that, so I decided to make this tutorial series. LSX is a great program. It has some unique capabilities, such as the real-time manipulation of effects, like with input of your mouse or from sound that's being played or MIDI input. You can change parameters in real time, and you can control how this happens extremely precise. Also, can use expressions like mathematical functions to change the laser effects that are being produced, also in real time. And that is a very unique combination, and that is what makes LSX so special. So if you start up LSX for the very first time, that is probably not going to be very interesting, because you get this screen. This means that LSX is not licensed, and this means that either your dongle is not inserted, but if it is the first time that you started up, it means that you also need a license file that you need to place in the program files folder of LSX. To get this license file, copy and paste this serial code with this button. I blurted it out because I guess it's not very wise to make this out in the public. Just press this button and email it to this mail address, and you should get an activation file, activation.lyc it's called, and put it in the program files folder. So when you acquired a license file, when you start up the program, you will hopefully get the following window. This is the standard LSX timeline. Get used to this window because you will see it a lot. Okay, so the first thing you might want to do when this is the first time you use a program, is to assign a controller to the program. To do this, go to Edit and go to Edit DSC Controller Timeline Assignments. You get this window where you have here in this box a list of all the controllers that are not assigned yet. To assign a controller, just drag and drop it to one of these timeline boxes. Use timeline 1 by default. I have LSX Pro. That means I have all the 8 timelines. If you have basic, you only have 2. And if you have intro, you only have 1. If you have a controller connected, but it does not show up in this list, you can also force LSX to use the driver file by checking the corresponding box. As you can see, a lot of controllers are supported. So that's how you do that. The next thing you might want to do is to test out the output. To do this, go to the setup window. You do that by pressing either one of these buttons, or go to scanner setting, and edit global parameters. Then you arrive at this window. To quickly test out the output, you can press this button and select one of these 3 test frames. As you can see, it shows up in the preview window. Okay. While we're here, we can also do some optimization and correction. So as you can see, the output is too big to fit on the projection, so I'm going to apply some corrections. I can reduce the size by using these sliders. Also notice this button. If I uncheck it, I can adjust it separately. I can adjust the X and Y size separately. Also, I can set it to a negative value to mirror the output. And if I check this, they move the same. I can also shift them like this, or rotate. Clipping, that removes a part of the output. And you can also apply geometrical correction, keystone, by playing around with these corners. Make sure this flag is checked, otherwise it won't have effect. Like that, okay. Also notice how you can save it. And load it again at a later moment. You can also set the optimization settings. Okay, for these test streams, you need to change scan parameter number 31 test stream. But I think this is not available in the intro or basic. So keep that in mind. So you can reduce the point rate. This image explains pretty much what all these sliders do. So for example, max distance drawn is distance between two points that are on. When I reduce this, six will add a lot more points because this distance is very small, so there need to be a lot of points, so the output will get flickery. When I increase it, it won't look very sharp, but it will look, but it won't have so much flicker. Same for max distance blanked. Can set it to whatever value you want. Also good to know is that it can add extra points here and here to remove the tails. Notice how now I have a tail in the upper left corner and now it's gone. This is also very helpful to remove the tail, to remove the gap I have, just like that. Other setup windows are the color palette. You can just load one. Okay, for some reason mine are always white. I messed up somewhere in the past, just ignore that. Can see no change to the correct colors. You can have static effects, DMX, and DMX mapping. Also, you can adjust the main size and scale independent of output targets of the DSC. This is helpful when you have a show where you want to have multiple output targets. But maybe you want to have one frame played like that and another frame mirrored. But this allows you to, when you do this, to also have the same main size or invert X, invert Y. Color mapping is also very helpful. I have a blue only projector, so all colors are mapped to blue. Color linearity is also very helpful. My blue does not modulate very well, so you can just edit it like that. And it will, like for a DPS green, DPSS green, it can also be very helpful. You also have safety zones, like this. Default test stream is pretty good at explaining this. No, this is the default one. The safety zone is applied to the blue part of this window. You have two zones that you can set separately. If you move this slider downward, you see a part of the output is getting blocked. Notice how this happens before the geometrical correction I did here. So I reduced the size. So for example, this box shows up much bigger than you would expect in the actual output because I applied geometrical correction. So keep that in mind when you do it. You can also move this all the way up so this becomes gray, and then the slider will reduce the global output. So that's very helpful to know if you want to do, if you want to keep your shows safe. Also, you have OSC control and external MIDI control. So I think this is a good point to stop. See you again next time, and thanks for watching.